What's happening, guys? My name is Scott Mendenhall, and this is...
I'm Lily Wiener. Welcome to the Whatever blog.
This is not a commercial that you want to skip. Actually, click it because we are leveraging Good Friday. We're going to talk about what is Good Friday, why is it good, and how it could change your life. So go ahead and click this video and enjoy an experience that will change your life forever. We're actually shutting down the Mall of America. We've been here all day in the tundra of Minnesota, and they're shutting the lights off on us, and we're out of here. But I hope you enjoy our race on a boosted board. She chose a pink penny board.
It was awesome.
And find out who won on a Good Friday. Thanks for watching, guys. Enjoy this video right here. We are at one of the highest points in Austin. What's it called, Kathy?
Mount Bunnell Park.
We are journeying out here to get some great footage. View of the Austin River, I believe it is. And we're gonna shoot some video for our Good Friday video that we're gonna be posting on our YouTube channel.
Where's the little one?
Right up here. Holly's a little concerned with the little ones, rightfully so. Look at these,
Daddy,
these two.
It's easy to get up.
Yeah, but come on up. Where's greatness? Is this making Mama Bear?
Makes me nervous.
Why?
Because we don't have the most graceful children, and they trip a lot. You get that from your mama.
Spectacular view in Austin. If you are visiting in Austin ever, this is a spot to come take pictures. It would've been a great video, but the danger of the children going over said cliff makes it very hard to be able to shoot a video. So, we've come up, we've seen, we've conquered, we're out of here now.
Tomorrow.
Good morning to everyone on this great Good Friday. And how can it even be a good Friday when it's surrounded with tragedy? Stick around for the whole thing. Our hope is to create an experience today that you will learn about Good Friday, what's the point, and even to help you deal with the merry-go-round of life. Do you feel like you're just stuck going around and around and around in life with no real answers? Where do you put your hope? How do you deal with the things in life? Love to answer the question, why is it called Good Friday when tragedy strikes? Because the tragedy that happens on Good Friday, an innocent man proven guilty of nothing but loving the unlovable and loving the lovable and serving the most unlikely people, doing life with those that would cause his being arrested and then being put on trial and his death. He did all of that for those and those of us today. And my hope is to unpack an idea of Good Friday, the Easter story, that involves all mankind. Those that are in Austin, Texas, those that are in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and everybody in between those two cities, in East and West around the world. Jesus came and did what he did for every ethnicity, for every culture, for every country, for every city. It's not limited to a few, and it's not suggested for only the wise and the smart and the wealthy. It's for everyone. And Jesus gave his life. He died a tragic death, being crucified on a cross, so that it sets up what happens 3 days later on Easter. Without the Good Friday, you won't have Easter. Without the tragedy, you miss the setup of something great. I always say it this way, every setback is a setup for something God is going to do that's going to blow your mind. And inside the Easter events, the tragedy on Friday is the setup for what happens on Sunday. And maybe you feel for yourself that you're stuck on the merry-go-round of life, just going round and round with no hope, lost your dreams, lost your job, lost your family, lost everything, and you don't know what to do because you can't get off the merry-go-round. We're currently back in Minnesota and we are working on our Good Friday service. It's gonna be epic. But it's one small problem, it's a major problem. I've never crashed the DJI drone before, but I just did. It's an epic shot. I mean, it was backing up and I ran into a tree right here and it's stuck in a tree. This is the tree. And it goes way up there. Ah! I'm gonna have to climb it. Recruiting Lily's help back here. Look at her, she's getting the ladder and everything. She got all dialed up for the video shoot, but now she's got to help get ladders. I'm not sure if this is gonna work. I know the propellers broke off.
You crashed the drone. Did you take a drone flying course?
Yeah,
That doesn't look like you did.
Wait, it hasn't crashed actually, it just ran into a tree.
You crashed a drone and this is like
this is the rescue mission.
This is a setback.
This is a setup for something great.
The crashing of the drone?
No, we didn't crash it. We got stuck in a tree.
Intentionally?
No, we got it stuck in a tree. But this is a great rescue mission. That's what it's turned into.
I'm not convinced. Yet.
Okay, now hold on. I'd like to point out, you have white shoes
I'm not
on.
I'm going in there.
And you've got to go. Just get over those puddles. Wait, what are you doing? Go over where it's the narrow spot. Oh my gosh. Hold on, I gotta help her. Did you just hit yourself in the head? Oh, look at this. She's a genius, folks. Lily's a genius. We have a ladder going to right there. I tried to shake and shake everything on that tree. I got bark in my sleeves. I'm gonna makeshift something I think that can reach out to it and knock it down. The question is, if we knock it down, what condition is the drone going to be in? Because right now it's just broken blades. Why do you find this romantically funny?
Romantically?
Yeah, why are you laughing at your husband?
Because we're hugging?
No.
Romantic?
I'm not hugging you, I'm just trying to get warm.
No, I just chuckle.
Here's Lily trying to bring our contraption out. She's riding it like a broom. Oh my gosh. Drone way up there, ladder, climb, you get the drill. New idea with a pipe that we've just taped together. The problem we have is knocking it out of the tree, then it has to be caught, because right now only blades have been broken, but as soon as it hits the ground, it's over, drone over. New development in strategy to catch. Holly has come onto the scene with a blanket. What's the goal here, Hal?
We're using my brain power for this as well.
And what does that mean?
Hopefully it means we're going to get the drone out without it breaking.
What are we using the blanket for?
We're going to use the blankets like when you're in elementary school and you have those parachutes that you hold on to all the corners.
Yep.
And we're going to hope to catch it.
Mm-hmm. It looks like it's intact.
Maybe missing a couple propellers?
A lot of propellers are missing. But, well done, Hal.
Hey, thanks.
Great idea with the blanket. Lil, how'd you think it all turned out?
That's ridiculous. I can't wait to see how Good Friday turns out.
It's going to be a good Friday.
We just got a miracle on Good Friday. We got the drone fixed. Good job, Lily.
Victory is sweet.
On to the Good Friday service. Let's head to the Mall of America.
We should race there.
I like it. Let's race. I challenge you to race me on a skateboard.
It's on.
We're going to skateboard from my house in Maple Grove to Bloomington, Minnesota, the Mall of America. Best person wins. Woo!
Moments later. One eternity later.
Going inside to find the merry-go-round because we are talking about, are you caught on the merry-go-round of life? That's the idea here. Lily just caught me. Excited to talk about the topic here about being on the merry-go-round, but we need to stash these boards. Just put the boards right here, Lily. Tickets are purchased. Thank you. We're in. Now we gotta find our ride. We get to pick our ride. Not much like in life, you don't get to choose yours. Here's my ride. Here's my ride right here. Don't you wish in life you got to pick what you rode on or what life was like? The deal about merry-go-rounds are, this merry-go-round at least, there's someone that's making sure I'm safe, that I'm riding correctly, and I get off when it's time to get off the merry-go-round. However, in life, it doesn't work like that. The merry-go-round of life goes around and around and around.
About that merry-go-round I just rode is that it's safe. It only lasted 1 minute, and I knew that I was gonna get off and go on with my evening. But that is not the merry-go-round of life. The merry-go-round of life has you all up and down, round and round and round, and you don't know when it's gonna end. For me, it's stressful. It's the stresses of worrying about my future, the stresses of, am I gonna make it for rent this month? The merry-go-round of life never ends, and we're here tonight on YouTube asking the question, what's the solution? If the merry-go-round of life seemingly never ends, what's the solution? How are we gonna get off? We want you to leave a comment below. What is your solution to this merry-go-round of life? How are we going to solve the round and round and round of the merry-go-round of life?
Now that we have our coffee, we're ready to finish the thought of how do you get off the merry-go-round of life. Lily, what do you think most people do to get off the merry-go-rounds of life?
I think there's a lot of solutions we think are the right ones, but for me, I just keep worrying and I keep pressing it down until somehow it goes away for a little while and gets brought back up again, and I keep pressing down. That's what I do.
I think as we're just in the Mall of America and watching all these people walk around, I know that so many people are self-medicating, they're getting addicted to substances, and they're changing relationships and jobs and locations thinking that's gonna get them off the merry-go-round of life. But what I have learned about the merry-go-round of life is you jump off a merry-go-round moving in life, it's not like the one we just got off, it's not a soft landing. You actually jump onto another merry-go-round, and that merry-go-round is more violent than the last, and it just keeps compounding itself, it gets larger. And the event of Good Friday through Easter is the events that actually will change your life and get you off the merry-go-round of life. Now, this is something that you have to choose to take a hold of. You can't just hear it and not do something about it. You've got to actually believe. I mean, let's get down to the most basic verses from the Bible, which is John 3:16, which says what?
Whoever believes in Jesus shall have eternal life.
Yeah, it's simply coming down to, it's a belief, it's a matter of belief in this. Do you believe the Easter story? Maybe you stumbled into our channel because of the title or your Good Friday, what is it?
Yeah.
Man, we're trying to help you that, man, this what Jesus did and transpired over 2,000 years ago is a game changer. It's an absolute game changer. Do you believe it? If you do, that changes everything. And today is a reminder what Jesus did on this great Good Friday. My drink is oozing everywhere. Like, I can't even. I actually didn't get any. Would you tell me if I had something on my lip? I actually got nothing to drink. I just got caramel stuck to my lips. How can we possibly get on with life here? This is like the merry-go-round of life. I actually want something to drink, but I can't. Oh, I got some there. That's really hot. Oh, that's hot. Oh my gosh, it's hot. What I have found in my life that works the most when I feel caught and I feel distraught and I feel alone is that I remember that Jesus still sits on the throne, which means this, that the events that transpire this weekend, it happened. And he lives and he's not dead and he's not getting conquered and he's not being thrown over from some coup of a thrown over of by a government. Jesus still sits on the throne. I want to read really quick from 1 Corinthians chapter 5. It's a letter to Corinth, which is a church plant in Corinth, that Paul writes to help instruct people about this belief in Jesus. And what does that mean? And maybe as you're watching this, you're going, great, these events transpired of Jesus over 2,000 years ago. He died on a cross. Great. What does it mean for my life? Here's what it means. Paul puts it so well in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. This means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. The old you, the old way of thinking, the old way of speaking, the old way is gone. There's no more of the old, it is brand new. Now, the question is that true for you?
I love that verse because it puts into a practical way of, if I'm gonna say I'm deciding to believe that Jesus did what he said he was going to do, he went to the cross, he died, and what we see happen on Easter is he rises again. And if I'm going to say I will believe, Jesus, that you did that, then that verse that Scot read, it puts it practically for us. It says the old life is gone. So that means, okay, if I'm gonna believe that Jesus did what he said he did, my old life is gone. The way I used to worry, it's gone. The way I used to handle my problems, the carousel of life, it's no longer present in my life, and now I get to start fresh. I get to start new with Jesus and my new belief in him. And there are ways where he says, let's do life together. Let's walk together so that this new life isn't just you doing what you used to do because that's gone. It's doing what I am advising you to do. And that's the beauty of being a follower of Jesus. He walks right here with us and helps us through it all along the way.
And we have a great illustration to illustrate this point. So let's get to it. Adidas off, all Nike back on. I feel so much better. All that boosting, boarding around got me dirty. Here's the point we're really trying to illustrate, is that when you choose to believe in Jesus, it changes you, not from the outside. I know that I've got a change of clothes from the outside, but it happens on the inside. That's why it changes the way that you think. Yeah, hold on, we got some guys that are, yeah.
Shoe magic, just showing up something good for the shoes, bro.
Yeah, they're brand new, so I mean. In Minnesota, you better waterproof your shoe.
It's all natural. There's no bleach, no alcohol, no ammonia. Cleans all kinds of shoes, waterproofs all kinds of shoes. From leather, suede, vinyl, nylon, fabric, mesh, canvas, nubuck, to cloth, fabric, any material possible.
Sorry about that momentary pause when you're shooting real life stuff in a real life place. Gotta talk to people. And we just got the brand new shoes waterproofed. Even adds to the point even more than what we had a second ago, is that, man, when we give our lives to Jesus, which means I believe that Jesus did what he said he was gonna do for my life, it changes us from the inside out. This is just an illustration of what happened on the inside. So if you're making the choice right now to say you believe in Jesus, then that's a game changer. If this is a reminder of what Jesus did on this Good Friday, which, why is it good? We talked about it earlier ago. It's a setup for the greatest story to be completed in 3 days. It's the setup. It's not the setback. And in your life, maybe you feel like you're in the setback. You're sitting there right now, and it is a setback for you. You lost your job. Your life isn't going the way you thought it should go, and it is a setback for you. Really view it as it's a setup for God to do something great. And great is defined by him and not by you and I. However, we want to define it ourselves. Let your belief in Jesus change your life forever. Believing in Jesus changes everything. This relationship with Jesus is not rules and regulations. Let me illustrate something really quick. All right, you see Lily over there. That is right here. That's Lily. Now I'm over here. There is a gap between Lily and I. Lily represents God, and I represent mankind. There's a gap between us because of the wrong we've done. The Bible calls that sin. I know what you think when we say sin immediately. You're like, there's that big Christian word all of a sudden. And I don't mean to use a Christian word. It's just, it's a word to illustrate that you and I have missed the mark, that we're not perfect, that we lie, that we sometimes tell white lies, which is still a lie. Maybe we spend longer on lunch than we're supposed to. We aren't perfect. Jesus comes on the scene to fix this gap between us and God. When we believe in Jesus and what he did on Good Friday, it takes this gap between Lily and I, or God and I, it's an illustration again, and Jesus becomes the bridge between the two of us, which then puts us in the right standing with God. Here I am, next to Lily. This is an illustration of what happens when you believe in Jesus. He is the bridge back to God. Lily is not God, okay? She's the illustration. Now look, I'm in a relationship with God, with Lily. I can talk with her. Jesus is the bridge. Anything else you want to add to that, Lil?
It's all about how Jesus is not even a dictator. So we built this bridge is built for us, and we get to go across it, have a relationship with God, and then we're walking with Jesus through life. But Jesus isn't saying, here's what you have to do, here's what I'm making you do. He doesn't hold anyone captive. He's not a dictator, but he knows how we best function. His Father created the world, created how you and I, and how we best will live our lives. And so Jesus isn't a dictator. He's not going to tell us what to do, but our outcome will be far greater if we walk through life with him.
Jesus is the bridge back to God, because God ultimately wants to be in relationship with the very thing he created, and that's you and me. I would like to invite you, and I know Lily wants to invite you if you're in kids, if you're a kid, we want to invite you to believe in Jesus. Get the old you off and become a new creation in Jesus. May this be an illustration to you today how to live your life, and may this change you forever. That's my point with all of the new outfit, even down to the shoes, is that when we decide to believe that Jesus did what he said he was going to do, we are brand new. That means that our past is forgiven. The wrongs that we've done to somebody, the words we said to someone, the regrets that we have in life are erased when we decide to trust in Jesus. Now, this is up to you. This is something you have to decide. All the worst things you've ever done in your life, the things even as I speak now that you still hold on to, are erased if you believe Jesus died on a cross and rose again. That's the beauty of the setup with Jesus dying on a cross. It's the setup to the best story ever told and the best true story to ever happen, is that Jesus wasn't dead forever. He died on the cross for 3 days and rose again. And in that process is our hope and where we get our forgiveness. Do you believe that? Because if you do, your past is done. Now, we've got to ask for forgiveness. It's, God, forgive me for the wrongs that I've done, the things I've said that I shouldn't have said. Forgive me. It's up to you, and I invite you in to do that. I am so glad my family is here to help illustrate the last bit of our Good Friday service. We need them. We almost have 12 here, which we needed for the last bit. They have graciously been here at the mall all day with us, staying on the other side of the camera, hidden from you, but they're gonna illustrate the last point here. And if you're sitting out there, this is a portion where you're gonna need something to drink and some kind of bread.
Our day up here at the Mall of America. It's been an incredible, fun experience here. And we want to wrap this up with an opportunity to do communion. And what it is just a simple time where we get to remember what Jesus did on the cross. He sat with his friends at a table at their last dinner together, and he said, let's do this as a symbol. And we're finishing up at Noodles. Actually, we grab a bite to eat. And I asked the lady, I said, do you have some bread? And some juice. And it really doesn't even matter what it is. Jesus just wants us to use this as a symbol in remembering him. So the bread in the Bible, it says, take this bread as a symbol of my body. It's what my body did for you on the cross, and remember me as you take it. And then the juice, Jesus says, take this wine as a symbol of my blood. It's remembering Jesus's blood shed on the cross. And just take this as an opportunity to remember, whether you're with your family or with your friends, what Jesus did many, many years ago for all of us on the cross on Good Friday.
Mall is shutting down, so it's a sign that we need to get out of here. I really hope you've enjoyed your Good Friday experience with us. Remember how we started the day in Austin, met Lily at the house, got a drone stuck. Talk about the merry-go-round of life today. Here's what I do understand about the merry-go-round of life, is that it can happen in a split second, from a phone call to a drone getting stuck to a text message that somebody's ending their relationship with you, and immediately you join in on the merry-go-round of life. And Jesus came to give us a way off those merry-go-rounds of life and into a relationship with him, and it's all on us to take the step. And so I hope you took a step today, and that you have begun a brand new relationship with Jesus, or today you're reminded of what Jesus did for you over 2,000 years ago. Thanks for watching. Would you subscribe to our channel? Maybe share this experience to somebody else.